Welcome to Trello Build GST release. Now we are going to see how to upgrade your existing Trello Build software to compatible with GST compliances. First of all, once you run the new exe, you need to go to File/Windows menu and click on Update Software. Once the software is updated, you will see this message: GST related updates and configurations done successfully. If your software version is older than April 17, press yes. If your software is updated after April, then press no. If you have already a version which was updated after April 2017, you just need to click on no button. So here I'll be clicking no. Now your software is upgraded and updated as per the GST compliances. So first thing you need to do is go to master entry, click on tax master entry. Here you have to define what sort of taxes will be applicable to your business. We'll click on add new. In this you have to create GST heads. So basically as of now I have only one. Let me click on N button, new. Here I'll create one more head, say ready-made. Ready-made. Description can be anything, say RM. And as ready-made, GST compliances for ready-made is value-based. 0 to 1000 would be charged 5% and 1000 and above would be charged 12%. So click on value based and save. Once you create this, let us create one more for fabric. Click on add, say fabric. This is another GST head you are creating. Fabric. It is not value based because fabric is having only fixed GST rate of 5%. Let's click on save button. Now we are going to see two type of GST compliances. So first we will select fabric. In fabric, title can be anything, for example general. This title is not actually going to be used anywhere, but just for your understanding, if you are creating multiple head within multiple taxes within a single head, so you can have like slab one like this. Okay, then go to central CGST. So CGST can be like for fabric 2.5% and state GST would be 2.5%. So interstate GST is automatically 5%, as you can see here. Now you have to define validity. So first of all, we'll say 1st of July 2017 to, you can define anything, say 31st of 3rd 2018. So after 2018 you can extend, you can just come and change the validity date, or even you can set for 3-4 years also. Now let's click on save. So your fabric GST is created. Let's create another one for ready-made. Go to ready-made, say RM. Okay, here you can say below 1000. Okay, this is the title, below 1000. So go to central GST, say 2.5%, and state GST 2.5, so it's total 5. Minimum should be like 1 rupees to 999 or 1000. Okay, now validity again, 1st of July to say 31st March 19, anything, say click on save. Now here you can see we are creating multiple GST slabs within single GST head ready made. It is above 1000. Okay, so leave interstate GST, go to central GST directly, CGST, and enter 6%, state would be 6, so interest rate is 12 by default. Now here you can write 1,012, anything, if you whatever your maximum sellable price is, say 20,000. Now 1st of July 2017 to 31st of March of 2020. You can anytime you can change the validity date. If you have, suppose after 6 months, if you get new compliances of any different taxes, so you can just change the validity date, and accordingly the software will calculate your taxable values. Now exit this, as we have created required GST compliances. The other thing is, next thing is, you need to go to subcategory. Here earlier we had some subcategory. Okay, now let me just check if I have any category for ready-made. I'll go to item category. Here I'll add a category, say ready-made maintain stock true, sale type Sahara Enterprises. I want barcode for this category, so I'll save it. Now I'll say fabric maintain stock sale type category Sahara Enterprises. I don't need barcode for fabric, so I'll say like this, save. If you need barcode, you can click on barcode, there is no compulsion. Exit. Now let's go to subcategory. Here in item subcategory, you can just select ready-made and subcategory say regular. Okay, because we are going to define regular and premium. So in this we have ready-made. Now you have to define this tax would be calculated inclusive or exclusive. So here I'm selecting inclusive, enter. So ready-made, regular. Now again ready-made, premium category, premium subcategory, ready-made and inclusive, save. Now fabric, for fabric I'll say, for example, subcategory is standard. Okay, now I'll say fabric, it is again inclusive, save. So here this way, if you have any existing subcategories, you just need to edit them and change the category tax value head and tax calculation type. For example, for general safety item we have selected exclusive tax calculation and safety tax slab. For others we have inclusive. Now exit. So this is what actually is required to this one settle up, start your GST calculation. Now let's go to purchase entry. I'll show you how the purchase will happen. Now here we have a new you can say user interface, updated interface, Sahara, enter, reference invoice number, the invoice number which you have received from your supplier, enter, purchase date, you can say 5th of July, enter, purchase type, we have to interest rate. If you are buying from another state, then you can select interest rate, otherwise interest rate, enter, say Alpha Fashions is your supplier, enter, mobile number, if you have, you can put the mobile number, enter, email address, if you have alpha@gmail.com, address, anything, okay, if you have, GST number, here is the play, you have to enter GST number of your supplier immediately, so that your interest rate and interest rate would be defined. So once I click, once I press enter, okay, here I'll say what item I need to purchase. Leather hand gloves, I have only one, so sorry to interrupt your this purchase system, because we need to have some ready-made outfits. Let me just cancel this. I'll go back to item master, sorry for this. Let's go to item master, create some ready-made outfit, ready-made. Now here you will define regular or premium. Say regular, say shirts. Okay, basically you don't need something, anything like this, but I'll explain how it works. Numbers, default discount, leave it, save. Now this is shirt you have created. Then again regular, say trousers, enter, say numbers, enter, save. So we have created three items. within redeem it, and here you can see the number of categories we have: safety item, leather and gloves, ready made shirts and trousers, fabric we don't have any. So let me create one fabric item, say fabric standard suiting. So this is suiting, suiting. This is fabric item, meters of would be the unit. Enter, save. Now let me exit this. Now I can go to purchase. As we have seen earlier, purchase. So I am just forwarding it. Alpha fashions. GST number. Here you can see the list of items, shirts, article number. This article number can be anything you can define. For example, alpha fashion, so I'll say AF and I'll say 001. Okay, size. If it's like shirts, so you can say 38, color blue, quantity 5 pieces, purchase rate 450. Profit margin, here you can say you want to work on 70% margin, so MRP is 765. If you want to change MRP, you can say 799. Enter. So now profit margin, you would be working on 77.56%. Enter. So you have corrected, you have purchased shirt, say AF01 again, and here you say 40 number, color leave it. Enter. Purchase rate 485, saleable price 850. Okay, now here you can go for trousers. Trouser you can select AF TR001, number 32, color leave it, quantity 3, purchase rate 1199. Saleable price 1649. This way you have made the entries. Now if you get any discount from your supplier, you can see here. Otherwise you can see total IGST. Now you will ask why it is IGST. Because the first two letter of your GST number of your supplier defines the state, which is actually not matching with your current company state. That is why it has taken it to interstate calculation. And now interstate calculation was dependent on your price range. So basically what we have is two items are below 1000 and one item is above 1000. So above 1000 would be calculated at this one 5%. I'll save it. Okay, so here you can see 992 is your IGST. Okay, and this is the excluding tax calculation system, not including. Okay, now I'll say exit. Here I have not generated any barcode, so if I need to generate barcode, I'll select this, and as barcode is disabled from setting, I'll just activate the barcode from here. Barcode enabled, save, exit. And in item master, I'll need to define these items would need multiple barcode. Shirts would need multiple barcode, and trouser will also need multiple barcode. Save. Now I'll say exit. I'll go to purchase entry. Here I'll see print barcode button. I'll select this, click on print barcode. So now you can see the barcodes are generated. Whatever label you have designed, accordingly you will get the barcodes. Exit this. Exit. Click on sale entry. Press enter. Here you have to select the customer, say sample customer. If you have mobile number, you can enter the mobile number. Otherwise, it is directly went to barcode. Now if you say you don't want to select customer every time, go to software setting, software setting, go to sale purchase tab, select default customer and select sample customer as your default one. You can create any cash customer or something and select customer there. Then you enter and it is directly to the barcode box. So here you will need to scan your barcode, but as of now, as I don't have barcode scanner with me, I'll just select search the barcode from here. So you can see 555 times 0 34 is the barcode number I have. 5 times 0 34, enter. So this is the barcode, 799. So CGST SGST is calculated as per 5%. So let me just show you how it works. It is including tax system. So 799 multiplied by 100 divided by 105, so 761. So you can see 761, 799 minus 761, 38 rupees is the charges, and 38 divided by 2, so 19 rupees. So when I say 799 multiplied by 100 divided by 105, it says 761. Okay, now there is a minor. Okay, it is excluding tax. It has calculated tax as a excluding one, so it has to be done on an including basis. Okay, it is calculating excluding, that is why 799 plus this one. Say don't go for including. 799 plus 5%. So here you can see 39.95, enter. 838.95. So 839 is the total bill value. Now if you want to give any discount, you can say give here, press enter. Now the discount taxable value is 719, and accordingly after discount is 759, and the tax is calculated accordingly. Okay, so here is 719 rupees is the taxable value. Click on save. You want to print? No. Now you must be having some new print formats. So if you don't have, let me show you print preview. This can be the new print format of your taxable invoice, which will have CGST, SGST and IGST as the parameter in invoice itself, and it will show you the total value of your sale. 834 is this. Okay, 795 is the bill value. Now let me exit this. So this way your GST compliance would be ready. Now you can see in account ledger we have proper posting of your GST accounts. Say IGST out, show. You have actually, when you purchased fabric from Alpha Fashion, you have paid 992 rupees IGST against purchase bill number 123652000. Your sale bill posting is not yet made because the status is pending at the moment. To make the payment, you can click on pay now and define that you have received 795 rupees from your customer, pay now. So once you make the payment, you can get the invoice again. But at this point of time, you can see we have made the ledger entries for your transaction, CGST in, CGST, SGST in, and your this one customer, sample customer. Let's see, sample customer has purchased 795 rupees product. Now sale cash in hand, 795 received from this one. CGST in, you can say sample customer has given 17.98 rupees CGST, and SGST in, 17.98 rupees from sample customer in SGST. And is there any round off? Yes, round off is -01, out round off minus, this is 0.36. okay, this way your ledger balance will be managed. Okay, thank you for joining us. If you have any queries or concerns, please feel free to contact us and we will definitely help you.